The database perspective contains various resources used during analysis of your DIA data or during spectral library generation. For example, here you can find protein databases. Spectronaut already contains the UniProt parsing rule, but you can add a new rule by clicking New Rule in the Protein Database page or later during importation of a chosen database. Using the option Import, you can start importing a new proteome database from FASTA. Spectronaut will try to find appropriate parsing rule for this file format from the list of already specified rules. Once your new protein database is imported, it will be available in the database tree during the library generation or analysis setup. Next step in the database perspective is modifications. This page includes a comprehensive list of modifications, like labels, tags, and high variety of naturally occurring PTMs. Modifications contained here are used for searches performed in Spectronaut, but also serve as a modification definition resource. This resource will be used for the automatic detection of modified sequences in search engine output whenever you create a spectral library from an external search engine. If you use any special modifications, you can simply import the corresponding modifications file into Spectronaut, or you can specify a new custom modification. In order to do that, simply select the new modification option. Give it a name, specify the chemical formula of the modification and the amino acid residues that this modification applies to. Moving on, we can find cleavage rules. The tree on the left side contains proteins digestion rules, which correspond to proteases most commonly used in proteomics. Those digestion rules will be used to in silico digest your proteins from the protein database used in each experiment, either during library generation or direct DIA workflows. Using options in the bottom left corner, you can also specify your new digestion rule. The next database tab is linked to Gene Ontology, GO databases. Information included here will be used to further annotate your data. This annotation will be used for calculating term enrichment and give further biological insight into the differential abundance results. The GO database section manages two different data structures, gene ontologies and gene annotations. Gene ontologies will allow you to import complex gene ontology structures in the shape of graphs. These structures are used for hierarchical grouping of functions, components, and processes. The gene annotation file functions as a link between the protein identifier, UniProt accession number, and the GO tree. If you use gene annotations, Spectronaut will connect the protein entries of your analysis via the GO ID with the respective entries in the gene ontology to annotate your data further. Finally, the table import tab will be helpful if you would like to import spectral libraries generated using other resources. Spectronaut can remember column names in user spectral libraries. Once you import a new library format into Spectronaut, it will ask you whether it should store novel synonyms for column headers, which will be helpful for future uploads.